months ago.
Absolutely fantastic.
A lot of tomfoolery.
Higgins, I salute you.
Oh, nonsense. The city people got to know their own silly business.
Tonight, old man, you did it. You did it. You did it. You said that you would do it, and indeed you did. I thought that you would rue it. I doubted you'd do it. But now I must admit it, that succeed you did. You should get a medal or be even made a knight.
It was nothing. Really nothing.
All alone you hurdled every obstacle in sight.
Now wait, now wait. Give credit where it's due. A lot of the glory goes to you.
But you're the one who did it, who did it, who did it. As steady as Travolta, not a second did you falter. There's no doubt about it. You did it. I must have aged a year tonight. At times I thought I'd die of fright. Never was there a momentary lull.
Shortly after we came in, I saw at once that we'd easily win. And after that, I found it deadly dull.
You should have heard the oohs and ahs. Everyone wondering who she was.
You think they'd never seen a lady before.
And when the Prince of Transylvania asked to meet her and gave his arm to lead her to the floor, I said to him, you did it, you did it, you did it. They thought she was ecstatic and indeed aristocratic, and they never knew that you did it.
Thank heavens for Sultan Kapathi. If it weren't for him, I would have died of war.
Kapathi, dreadful
Angarian.
He was there.
Oh, he was there, all right. And up to his old tricks. That blackguard uses the science of speech more to blackmail and swindle than teach. He made it the devilish business of his to find out whose this Miss Doolittle is. Every time we looked around, there he was, that hairy hound from Budapest. Never leaving us alone, and never have I ever known a Budapest. And finally I decided it was foolish not to let him have a chance with her. So I stepped aside and let him dart with her. Oozing charm from every pore, he oiled his way around the floor. Every trick that he could play, he used to strip her mask away. And when at last the dance was done, he glowed as if he knew he'd won. And with a voice too eager and a smile too broad, he announced to their hostess that she was a fraud.
No!
Yavo! Her English is too good, he said, which clearly indicates that she is foreign. Whereas others are instructed in their native language, English people aren't. And although she may have studied with an expert dialectician and grammarian, I can tell that she was born Hungarian. Not only Hungarian, but of royal blood. She is a princess.
Okay.
gone, it's all over. Now I can go to bed at least without dreading tomorrow.
Good night, Master Higgins.
Good night, Miss Spears. Well, I suppose I shall turn in too. Higgins, it has been a grand occasion. Good night, Pickering. Oh, Miss Spears.